Hey, spiritual superstars, I'm Nicole, and I wanted to just talk to anybody out there who thinks that dimming their light, meaning hiding behind their fear of a conflict, or you don't want to rock the boat, but you find that you are hiding so much that you're losing yourself. I want to talk to you today. I want to talk to anybody who feels like they are less than other people around them. It simply is not true. And I want to talk to you, the soul within your human, but I want to encourage you to have a conversation with your human. Because your human is what's feeling all of that energy. Your human is feeling less than that low self-esteem. Your human is feeling like they just can't get it right. Your human is feeling the attack, and it's manifesting in the headache. It's manifesting in the addictions. It's manifesting in the ulcers. It's manifesting in the self-harm. And we want to talk to your human, but that's your responsibility. And so I'm going to minister, if you will, to you today, the soul within your human, because, honey, you are so much more than you even realize. And by the end of this video, I want you to step forward in the direction that will encourage your human to take a massive action, some form of positive movement that's tangible, something that she or he can be proud of as soon as we end this video. I'm Nicole Anrevi, founder and CEO of Spiritual Guidance Academy, the world's largest spiritual network that helps you master your spiritual gifts and how to hear from God. Please hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, share our video to bless others because you are a blessing to be a blessing, and hit that little bell so you'll be notified when we come back over with more free spiritual guidance. I used to be you, and there are some times in my life where I fall right back to my old self of people pleasing, of being afraid to step out there and sing Kumbaya if I feel like it around people that are singing rap and R&B or rock or classic, whatever it is. Dare to be different because you were created as such. And nobody else can do it quite like you. People can pretend to be you. They can call to check up on you to see what you're doing so that they can project their negative energy on you. Some people are going to be honest and upright and positive, but those energy vampires, those soul suckers, those drainers are going to contact you too. And it is in that moment where you realize there's someone negative on the other line. There's someone negative that just sent a text message to you. There's someone negative that's trying to get at you, where you have to say my favorite word, and it is the favorite word of all toddlers. What is that favorite word, dear parents, aunts, uncles, siblings out there, grandparents? You know it well. That word is no. But I didn't know how to say no. I didn't know how to show it. I could practice it, but I would practice it deep in my room, door closed. Sometimes I'd be in my closet crying. Why couldn't I say it in that moment that I felt it? I certainly saw it in my mind's eye. I certainly was screaming it inside of me, but I just could not, for the life of me, figure it out enough to say it verbally in that moment. That overwhelm, that burden, that was self-imposed, but it was certainly taught by society in that term, be seen, not heard. Kept my mouth shut. And so in my silence, in the corner of your space, in your car, in your home by yourself, in your room by yourself, while you're watching TV and you're slowly just whittling into a depressed abyss, a sadness that's making you break out in the hives, while your partner is right there, your husband is sitting right there, your wife is laying right there, while you watch TV, while you cook, while you clean, while you work on anything in the house, while you watch your game, you play your game, you do all this stuff, and you're inside, why can't I stand up for myself? Your child disrespects you. Your coworkers don't appreciate you. Your manager devalues you. And why doesn't that word no come out? I didn't realize that I could say it in different ways, and I certainly could act it out. And so one day, to my father, my biological father, I decided to stand up to myself and I said, no, absolutely not. And at that point, I had quit my job and went to go work for him and found out that the company was upside down, meaning it was in the red, meaning it was failing, meaning there was some trouble, meaning it was a huge gash in the boat and the ship was sinking and I had just joined the ship. And he never said anything to me about it. He let me walk in to a sinking ship so that I could save the ship and him. And when I realized he cared more about himself than he cared about me, was the moment that I gathered all the strength inside of me and I stood before him as one, but I came as 10 million with my ancestors behind me, all around me, on top of me, below me. They were inside of me. They helped me say no, 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 absolutely not, with a depth in my soul that I didn't even know existed. And he looked at me and didn't say a word. And I could feel my energy rise up inside of me, and I could feel God cover me with the tingling sensations and the waves of energy. And I could feel the prickles on top of my head. And I could feel my skin tighten because I knew what that felt like. I knew what that was. And that was my creator saying, well done. Girl, you did it. And that was my ancestors saying, we are so proud of you. They were clapping. They were joyful. They were celebrating me. And in that moment, I was totally confused, but I was so happy and I was scared all at the same time, and all I could do was walk away. And it was the right thing to do. See, when someone shows you who they are, believe them no matter who they are. And they may show you in behavior, they may tell you with their words, they may not tell you with their words, and they may lie straight to your face. But you will know deep in your soul that who they are is who you are seeing in that very moment. And what their intentions are, what their agenda is, you will see it very clearly. And the moment you don't say no, in your behavior, in your verbiage, in your mindset, you will be lying to yourself, and you will be putting yourself after them when you should put yourself first. And so that word no is so powerful. It's healing because it stopped me from breaking out in the hives, and it will stop you from sacrificing what you know to be true within yourself, your personal truth. Is what you have an obligation to share with the world, not to avoid confrontation because someone else shows you the opposite energy of what your intention is, when someone shows you they can't support you in your dreams, when someone shows you that they're not coming with you in your future, when someone tells you you are not going to be a part of their life, when they have chosen to leave you, when they have chosen to look out for their own needs, when they have chosen to enjoy the life that they live as an average life, and you have chosen to not be average, you get to say no. And you get to do it in multiple ways. And one of those ways that I learned to do it is very powerful, and I want to share it with you because it will help you grow and will help you put yourself first. One of those ways that I learned to say no was simply walking away. It took a lot of courage because I wanted to be heard, but what I was saying was the questions. Why? How? What? How could you do this to me? How could you say that? How could you not care about what I feel? What? Why did you say that? Why did you do that? Those questions didn't matter. I learned to use my resources. My resources are within me and always have been, and your resources are within you and always have been, and you are very resourceful. And so the next time someone shows you who they are and it goes against your values, it goes against your direction for your life, it goes against God's plan for you, and you know this to be true in that moment that you lose your voice, get it back by either walking away and knowing that you don't have to say anything in that moment. And sometimes you're going to be even more powerful and you're going to say, I don't know what to say right now, although I know that I don't feel too happy right now. Hearing what you just said, or experiencing what just happened, or what you just did, doesn't make me happy. Makes me feel sad, and I don't quite know what to say, but I do know how to make myself happy again. And I'm going to be over here, or I'm going to be in my room, or I'm going to leave now, or I'm going to go home, or I'm going to end this phone call now, or I'm going to go for a walk now. It's not saying to your loved ones, whom you really do love, but who may need to understand how to appreciate and value you, that you want to not have anything to do with them. You're saying you want to take care of yourself, and in this moment, you need to put yourself first. In that behavior, you will empower yourself, and I pray that this helps you. Those little simple techniques are humongous. They are powerful when you need it. I'm Nicole Henri V, and I pray that I have given you value today. Take great care.